Switching over. Ah, do you feel your pulse changing? I know you do. Get ready for Backstage Live, y'all. I know, reaching out, Neil Urban Internet Intergalactic Connections. Get ready for guitarist D. Brown tonight. Live into his house. You're going to love this one. Go home and tell your mama about us. It's going to be live.
I
like
the way. You know, I get to talk a couple of seconds here. Yeah, no, leave me alone. He always got to deal with Miko already. Miko,
I'm good.
You ready for the fallout? Because you know you fall out on the floor when you hear jazz. You know that, right?
I know, right?
Right.
You wrong for that.
Yeah. All day.
I don't need two pains in my thigh. I just need one.
Okay. Here we go.
So what's the use in trying? Destination, baby, all I know.
I think we got the chat room happening. The mistress of chat. Hot talk to Miko Williams in there. You know she's our ambassador to that world.
I know.
Social media.
Yeah.
Get ready. Music. Jazz. Flowing. Alternative. You're going to enjoy it tonight.
Okay, okay, okay.
Start the show, y'all. You know how we do it. Still pulling in. I know. I'm looking at you. They said something that's a little bit of a delay for my European people. One more song to get you guys tuned in. Get ready for Backstage Live. Tonight, our special guest is going to be guitarist D. Brown. We got the whole team in the house. Hot Chocolate Miko Williams, and always on the video switcher, the man recreating that world, Victor Allen. Get ready.
Bottle of wine, you whisper those life-changing words and lift me out of time. Where you end, I begin. You're my reflection, my connection to the whole. Into one, melting into one, melting into one, melting into one, a perfect circle round my finger.
All right.
Diamond that once
thank
was
you.
Stone.
Kazakhstan you just jumped in the room. Thank you. All right, we got everybody once we get to Soviet Union.
You're just wrong, man. You're just wrong.
Oh, I didn't mean it like that, y'all. I didn't mean it that way. I did not mean it that way. Y'all give me some international trouble.
That's just wrong.
You're my reflection. My connection to the whole.
For those of you who are just logging in, I want to say acknowledge your presence in that chat room. And remember, too, the new offerings for Paxtero TV. We're transmitting and broadcasting and streaming, as it were, in high def. Remember, you can watch us on live stream. Selectable, three speeds. Pick the one. If you're experiencing any delay or choppiness in your broadcast, pick a lower speed. Don't tax your system. We must remember we're also streaming live on Ustream. Again, mobile and high quality. For those of you on your phones, tune into the mobile stream. It'll save you money. That's right, save you money. Why waste it? This is Paxtero Live. Getting ready. We got everybody tuned in. Okay, thank you. Everybody's in, Miko. Yeah, for a broadcast like this, we wanted to take the time to make sure we pulled in the overseas. Sprechen Sie Deutsch.
You know what? Say something else.
Yeah, just watch out.
Say bon. I got one.
Fifi bon.
Okay, I'm working on it. Give me some time. You guys are not ready for this.
TNT.
You guys are not ready for this.
TOT.
I'm telling you. Look. When the guitar speaks, when the electric guitar speaks, you don't say anything.
Well, I guess he does.
You just roll with it. And Motor City in the house? Oh, man, come on now. You know, it's over.
You give these keys to me. Big Mac and Mini Me. Okay, got you. Okay. Watch out now. Darth Vader just spoke.
See, guys just don't know. You just don't know.
So tell us about him, Big.
Hey, look. Respect first. You gotta respect the game. And I respect the game. And the game is guitar. Now, I play some mean chopsticks. Yeah, I play real. Yeah, you guys haven't seen me with some chopsticks. Tell him, Miko. Tell him about my chopsticks.
It's called his two legs.
That's called.
He walked very well.
You're supposed to represent.
I was. You were in the
city. Well, get your chopsticks ready because you got 20 seconds. Ladies and gentlemen.
Man on stilts.
I'm watching the stream. I know. I see y'all. And lift me. Tuning in high def. Today's experiment. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody. That kind of a night. Vic?
Yes, sir?
We got to tell them the story about this. It's going to be a special night. The second show of the season, mm-hmm. Paxtero Live, the new 2015
yes.
show, live in studio, just hot items, hot people, 2015. And we're continuing on that trend tonight, but tonight is going to take it to a little bit more soulful stroke kind of a level, mm-hmm. because it's about music.
Word and, honey's in it, man.
And good music.
the word honey is in the music right
I'm
now.
I'm telling you, everybody, it's going to be a wonderful night tonight with our special guest, guitarist D. Brown, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. And that's not it. That's not just it. To make sure it's going to work well, we assembled the whole morning coffee crew, right?
Yeah, one person.
Over there, the mistress of chat. Hot chocolate herself, everybody. Miss Miko Williams, everybody. In the chat room, your ambassador, interpreting your needs and your wants. And the answer is wait. Just wait. Over there, my buddy, my partner in crime, Mr. Victor Allen, who is a man who's working three video switchers.
At least I'm a man.
I know. I've
while live
that.
On the air. At least I'm a man.
Get it, Mario. That was hilarious.
You'll have to take his word for all
that's
of
jacked
that.
Up, that's cold. Like, cold.
Everybody, my partner in crime, Mr. Victor Allen over there. Live.
Bam. How you guys doing?
Only person live on air with working three switches and being on air personality.
Crying, man. I got two fans.
You
got
to tell them, you know, you got to tell them about, well, I guess I had something to read.
Well, you know.
Tell them about how this guest came to be, and then I'll read.
Yeah, there you go. See, from his now you stuff. Got it. See, first of all, you got to give props to everybody. First, another blessed day to be alive and breathing. And
that's
I'm
right.
No doubt on this one, because I take every day, and I had this inspiration after I went to look at D. Brown's information. I said, you know, people making everything count every day. And so to me, the inspiration is that, you know, his music, I've already went and checked out everything, so I'm not going to tell you everything. It only took one phone call from Bridget Barnett, the Barnett Group. And she said, you know, she just does like this. She says, Victor, artist, give me the date. That's how she talks. That's it. That's it. That's how she rolls. And I want to give much props to Bridget Barnett, because she has a history here with Pax Stereo. She knows that we're grassroots. We're a former
right.
indie record label, so we understand the music business. And now we understand social media, and we understand technology. It's moving faster than you can breathe. Mm-hmm. And when you have somebody who's as talented as Steve Brown, and you know what talent is? Small D, bro. Small D, not capital. That's the part that got me. Small D. I kept
little D.
I was doing some word checks. I was going, it won't go capital. It won't go capital. Small D. That told me he thinks outside the box. Way outside the box. Oh, I followed you, bro. I got you. I got you on this one.
Well, then we ought to get him to make sure he explains that.
Right.
Right.
Here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our friend and artist, D. Brown.
Bam.
All right.
Hello, how you doing out there?
All right.
Yeah.
Glad to be here. Glad to be alive. Thanks for another day.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And you're just swinging by L.A. for a moment, right?
Right, right. We're here actually for the NAMM show. I'm sure a lot of people know about the NAMM show here. It's a big, big festival show where all the music manufacturers get together. They show off their new stuff. Mm-hmm. And the musicians go there to check them out. Do a little plan, do a lot of mingling, and hopefully, you know, get some endorsements.
Mm. Right. Now, tell everybody where you're from, D.
Well, you know.
Oh, you have to stop. Well, they have to stop it all.
I just want to start by saying all the things that you hear about Detroit are not true. So I'm hailing from the Motor City, Detroit, Michigan.
Uh-oh. I get some claps.
Thank you very much.
We
have
much love in Detroit, a lot of friends.
Yeah.
You know, and certainly we have been embracing the day when they get to have that comeback, and everybody knows it will be
absolutely
a comeback.
I have no doubt whatsoever right now. I mean, a lot of things that we read in the paper, a lot of things that you hear in the news are a lot of negative things. But if you actually came there, you see the downtown area, you see it all building up. You see the houses that are dilapidated, they're tearing them down, and they're building up new homes. So, yeah. You know, we are in the process of coming back, and it will be in the next 3 or 4 years. We will be back on the map.
All right.
So, well, Dee, tell us a little bit about your early days. See, one of the things I love about these shows is I actually get, in a very real way,
yes,
a chance to know you guys. That's why I try not to talk to you too much before the show, because then I get to, so my curiosities are. So, yeah, tell me about your early days, my brother. How did you get started in music? And why wasn't it, you know, building models or, you know,
you know, I
basketball.
I like the question you asked, because, you know, it's kind of like a long answer to that question.
That's what we got time.
And, you know, I don't want to bore you guys with, you know, my life, you know.
Oh, we want to hear.
But, you know, I like that, you know, we want to hear it. Can you hear that again?
We want to hear.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Say it one more time.
We want to hear.
Okay, here we go.
We're
going to start, you know, in the very beginning, and I'm going to make it short, but this is a long story. Basically, as I was growing up in my home, I'm the youngest of three, and my father is a jazz enthusiast. He was also a drummer, but his whole being was to take care of his family. So when he had his children, he could not pursue music as a career. So he went to work, and he worked in a packing company. But he did pass on the music that he loved to us. So he played jazz. Whenever he came home from work, he would play it all day. When he was home on the weekends, that's all we heard was jazz.
Wow. Like, what kind of stuff, D? Like, what kind of artists? Can you remember some of the artists he would play?
Of course. The artists that we know of today. I can go through some of the artists. People like Les McCann.
Okay.
People like Wes Montgomery.
Okay.
Charlie
Jimmy?
Christian.
I know who that is.
Charlie Christian. Miles Davis.
Okay, okay.
Cannonball Adderley. Herbie Hancock.
Okay.
I mean, it's just all the greats that we listen to and we call great today. And, you know, I was hearing like a lot of horn players. Mostly he played horn players a lot.
Okay.
And then one day he played this song. I'm about 1 or 2 years old. He played this song and I heard an instrument that didn't sound like a horn. So I said, Dad, what kind of instrument is that? And they're in their glory. You know, they're hollering and screaming, you know, doing their thing. And he says, son, that's a guitar. And I said, that's the instrument I want to play. And remember, I'm like 1 or 2 years old. I told him this. So time went on, you know, in my life, my mom really liked, you know, the Motown kind of music because we're from Motown. And all the singers, you know, like, you know, the Temptations. The
And at
Tops.
A time, that was the most happening
yeah.
news and really relevant social happening. I was there
right.
As a kid, too, but it was wonderful.
Right. So we listened to a lot of that kind of music. So I got the jazz and I got the vocal kind of music. Mm. And as I grew up... I later asked my mom for a guitar, and she said, well, ask your grandmother. Of course, my grandmother got me one. I was probably around 11 years old when I got the guitar. And from that point on, I mean, basically, I just continued to play. I continued to, you know, listen to different types of music besides jazz and R&B. I listened to rock and roll. I got into heavy metal. I played in a country band, you know, as time went up. As I grew up in high school, we had a band that was sort of like, I guess you could say like the Prince kind of thing that was out there. So, you know.
Because that was happening, right?
Yeah, that was what's happening.
Does that mean you were wearing those clothes?
Yes, I was.
Wish you had some pictures.
I had some pictures.
Wish you had some pictures.
You know, going down my back. I had like it on my shoulders, like as long as your hair was, but it was real hair. And it was curled and it was permed, kind of like your hair, but it was hanging down.
Oh.
It was very, very long. So, you know, if you like to see that video, it's in my song video that's on YouTube entitled Sonny. Oh.
Okay.
That's the song that I dedicated to my father. His name was George Sonny Brown. So I dedicated that song to him. And, you know, as time went on, we changed our style. Yeah. And I got into like a vocal group after high school and into the college days. We went into a vocal group similar to like the Boys and Men. And I wasn't even playing the guitar.
You
I
were
was just
singing?
A stand-up singer. Stand-up singer, did routines and dancing.
Really?
Yes. I was a singer, and I did sing. Now, if you want to see that, it's on YouTube, too.
We're going to go to that. We're going to go to YouTube.
You can go to that song, and we can really laugh. But, you know, I had my group there. It was called One Wish, and it was sort of like a Boys to Men, kind of like, you know, Jodeci kind of thing. And then I gravitated into smooth jazz because my mother one day asked me, she says, D. Brown, when are you going to play that guitar again? I said, you know, I think I should. And that's when I moved into smooth jazz. And I've been doing smooth jazz as a solo artist since 2006, I believe.
Wow.
That's a long story.
Now, we're going to go show some of these whenever you're ready. But the story is still so fascinating to hear how you began and got started. Now, again, this was growing up in Detroit?
Well, you know, what happened was kind of things diverged. I grew up, started out in Detroit, and my father, like I said, he was a serious dad. I mean, he was a dad, he was a father, he's my hero. And he really showed me what a man's supposed to be, how a man's supposed to act, and how he should feel about his family. So his whole thing was, I need to take care of my family. And my mother... she got very, very sick. She ended up having a heart attack.
No, no.
And they thought that she wouldn't be able to go up and downstairs. So my father said to the whole family, we're moving to a house that's completely flat. So then we moved to another town. And then I finished high school in Oak Park, Michigan. So all the houses there are ranch style.
Okay.
Yep. Oh, okay.
So that's where I finished up high school. And my mother is still with us today, so hey, she's doing great. She's doing great, she's strong. Yep.
You have, you know, looking at, I'm just looking around on YouTube. Mm-hmm. Got a few things up here.
Yeah, I got a few things. Now, if you want to see me sing, you got to put in one wish and put in the song, I Feel Like Getting Romantic.
Okay.
Because we were writing love songs back then, and we were trying to tell the guys of that day, you know, what and how to love their lover. I'm actually talking about their wife, but, you know, you can take it in context. So this may show me something.
Uh-oh, here okay, we go. Okay.
So, yeah, this is...
Let's see what it is.
I didn't say you had to play it.
Yeah, play it. Dude, play.
Okay, that's it. You know, this is a tune entitled I Feel Like Getting Romantic. Those are my three guys I sung with, D'Angelo Webster and his brother, Venturi Gaddis. And, they were guys who we grew up together, and they were in singing groups. And we met up in college and decided to put a band together and write a whole album. You know, and something very special about that album that I want to tell everyone, that all the instruments that you hear were played on the guitar. There's no keyboards in there at all. Everything you hear, I did on the guitar. So yeah, it's
like
all MIDI,
guitar synth.
MIDI guitar synth.
Oh, I own one.
Including the
drums. TR-1.
Include the drums.
Oh, that's hot.
Drum, everything.
Take a look.
Everything. And I did all the background. Right. It's me. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. And baby, I can't believe. No. Not with your sexy warm body lying next to me. Between the sheets.
Last guitarist that I've heard that could sing anything like that was Jonathan Butler. That's hot.
You just, and it's always a time to beg, you know, because
back then that's when they begged a lot.
So you wrote this song too?
Yeah, I wrote this song. I played the guitar. I'm doing all the background. The other guys doing lead with me. Wow. It's all done on guitar.
That's wonderful.
And that's my man Venturi Gaddis doing the first tenor. Probably one of the best first tenors on the planet. As I kiss your
body from head to toe. That is all cocaine Detroit. There's some history, you know. You want me to go with my love. That's right, D. Brown. We're talking, we're visiting with artist D. Brown. He's here to play guitar. We're going through his past. Take a look, you guys. We love to get the stories. This backstory and quiet story. Got the honey up there.
Okay, I'm listening, and they sound like silk a little bit.
This is like cable access or something, right?
Yeah.
But they blowing, see? Yeah, brother, this is cool. Hold you tight, looking at you lying so half asleep. Oh girl, you're looking so sweet. All I want you to do is lay back and listen. Now I'm gonna do you in all those wild positions. Girl, I know I seem a little different, but I can't help but wonder if you roll me. There's some video effects and stuff.
Oh yeah, I was looking at that. Don't it feel
right? I love indies. Creative.
I had a beard.
Whatever it takes. Yeah. Right, the track, I Feel Like Getting Romantic. That's one wish. That's right. Past endeavor of our featured guest tonight, D. Brown. Yeah, he got known around Detroit.
Mario, you can see that dance movie, dude.
That's what I said. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah. Yeah, everybody.
Oh, man.
I have to say, did y'all see him go?
Yeah, that was that was back in the day, you know. And
he kept bumping and
grunting. Wow. D. Brown, One Wish. Wow. No, because I think the history is important, you know, because life is such a journey. People like to think that things have just happened. Yeah. When they rarely have just happened, usually years and years of work and trial and effort and just the spirit that went into that. Mm-hmm. So once again, let's give it up for our guests. I like that. Enjoyed that. D. Brown. The group One Wish. So that's him at the early stage. Because tonight, you're going to get to hear him play some tracks. We're going to do a few things here tonight. So, wow. So now.
Wait a minute, Mario. Got a question.
Yes,
somebody
baby.
Sometimes on Facebook
late
wants
at
to,
night.
No, no, no. We're not
going
to go there. Somebody on Facebook said it's interesting to hear what he's done compared to what you've done. Is there ever a time you think that you and him will work together as they're currently doing something? Facebook question.
Well, I just met him.
Well, they just asked. Hello? Tell your fans that.
I'm always open. You never know. First of all, he knows almost nothing.
Ladies.
Really nothing about my ventures.
No, this not.
So
they're saying based on hearing him, you play that and based on.
Oh, yeah.
His
style of music.
Yes.
Yeah. And because we have a history.
Yes.
In other words,
see?
Pac Stereo has a history of
that's
working with artists. I know what you mean. And yes. Jazzy independence. Yes, that's true.
Yeah,
so you
see?
Never know. And we actually have a history of people from Michigan.
Yeah.
So you never know.
That was from the UK. That question.
Whose fault was that?
Her name is Yaya from the UK on my Facebook page.
Okay, thank
she
you, Yaya.
She wants to know that.
From the UK.
UK.
See, D. Brown,
yeah.
Miko is the mistress of chat, so she's out there working the world for you.
And but Renee Lee Kiss said you could have had her ass back in the day.
Ooh, whoa.
It's too late.
Hey,
it's too late now, Renee.
Go ahead, bro.
Oh, my goodness.
I thought that was my stuff.
Well, I guess I thought so, too, but she jumped over to
Sarah
him.
Well.
Wow.
Yeah.
OPP. OPP.
I'm happy that you, can feel what we were feeling at that time.
Good answer.
That's a good one.
So
good answer.
D, take us to the evolution then, okay? So, of D. Brown, because there's obviously been, and like a lot of artists, there's an evolution.
Yeah, that was, that was a time where, like I said, I really was into singing. And singing is something I studied in college, in songwriting, those sort of things, too.
Wait a minute, he said college.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I forgot to talk about college, didn't I? But
yeah.
I did say I was in college, and this was after college.
Yeah.
Well, tell us about college.
Okay. I'll do that.
Where did you go to school?
That's a great question, young man. I'm happy you asked that.
Did you say young man?
That's exactly
what
I said.
He's so nice to me.
Isn't he?
Young lady?
That's right.
Oh, he's really kind.
How you doing?
Oh.
All right, so this is, after high school, I was fortunate enough to have a scholarship. And I had a scholarship to the University of Detroit.
Okay.
Yeah, University of Detroit. Now, this
congratulations.
Thank you. And I decided that I really wanted to go to Eastern Michigan. But my father asked me, he says, where's the scholarship? I said, UD. He says, where you going? I'm like, okay, Dad. Because Dad knows. Mm-hmm. My father was a very large gentleman. And he was very intimidating, but he was very nice. But if he said it and he looked at you in a certain way, you kind of knew.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember only getting like one whooping. So anyway,
but
I ended up going to University of Detroit.
I feel you, brother.
I ended up going to the University of Detroit. And I went in as a business major. And I decided after I was in business, I really didn't like it so much. During the business time, I was taking, flamenco guitar. I was taking songwriting. I even went into orchestration, and I did a symphony while I was in college.
So you studied. So unlike, and again, I think it's important for a lot of folks to recognize that he had these kind of academic pursuits, because it sort of rounds out the character of D. Brown, right? I mean, not that you, it just makes you look at him a little,
Yeah, it does. Yeah. And he's not name dropping.
Yeah, he's a brother's name humble. The brother's humble.
We could do all the names, but the list is kind of long.
I'm digging it. I'm digging it.
I saw the list.
It's long.
I saw his list. Oh, yeah. My God.
Well, you know, that
tell us about the list. Who's on the list?
Oh, well, you know, read the list, Nico.
Nico, you'll read the list?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. I can say BB. And CC Winans, I can say Rick Franklin.
Oh, that's some heavy hitters.
I just give you a
there.
Head start. You know,
well, that I mean, how much bigger can you get?
Yeah,
that's, really.
That's I'm just big. Asking.
That's big.
Are we the Franklin?
Yeah.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it's a sort of thing where, you know, it's music, and basically, I'm there to do the job, and it doesn't matter who I'm with, I'm there to do what they need, and if I can give it to you, I'm giving you 100% all the time, every time I'm doing it. And if it's not what you want, then I'll bow out.
So when did you start working professionally like that? Were you still at school at University of Detroit? Or when did you start getting those paying gigs?
You know what? You asked a good question. And this is what I left out. Okay? Because you're really digging that, young man.
Yes,
I think you've done this before. But let me give you this information. You know, since I grew up in Motown, well, actually, I grew up in Detroit, and I moved to Oak Park, Michigan. But I was very fortunate to grow up next to a gentleman who was actually in Motown and had a Motown hit. I'm going to see if you guys remember this Motown hit, because it was a hit, but a lot of people don't remember it. His name was Eric McClinton. The song he had was Vibrations. The group was called Eric and the Vikings. I don't know if any of you guys remember that song. It was called Vibrations. And that gentleman was the one who gave me a lot of information about recording. He actually took me to a recording, my very first one, and he actually recorded me when I was probably like 13 or 14 years old, doing an actual recording in a studio. That's it.
He got it.
He got it.
We do this.
Okay, then that's the song.
That's the song. He don't know who you're talking to. You heard me? 2 years after he got his guitar.
Okay. All right. Everybody, Eric the Viking.
Eric McClinton was... He was like the gentleman that really made me... I mean, he gave me all the parts to the music business that were loose ends. How to go in the studio, how to prepare to go in the studio, how to write a song, what parts of the song are parts of the song, how to write a change, how to go in there and prepare to play, how to produce, how to get out the singing of a singer.
Wow.
He showed me all this stuff. And also another gentleman by the name...
See if I can get a picture, too.
His name was Paul Reiser. I don't know if you guys heard of him. Mm-hmm. He was a string arranger for Motown back in the day. He worked with Whitney Houston. He worked with all the Motown people, Stevie Wonder. He worked with everybody out there, R. Kelly, Gladys Knight. He was just a great arranger.
Is that him right there?
That's Eric. That's Eric McClinton. That's the guy. That's my man. You know, and Eric, we lost touch with Eric. He moved away from our house, and he moved to another city. And I made contact with him about 3 or 4 years ago, and then he moved again. So I haven't, you know, really heard from him since. He knows that, you know, I'm still doing music, and I played one of the songs on my very first CD that we wrote together. It was called Wings of Love. We wrote that song. Dave, the painter, who's here with me, he played the bass on that.
Oh, yeah,
it was
okay.
Produced by another good friend of ours named Gerald Mitchell. We call him Los Hermanos. And me and Eric wrote that song, and I was probably about 15 or 16.
Wow.
And I actually wrote it about a girl who was my girlfriend at the time. And it was entitled
Usually
Wings
Works That Way.
Yeah, he finished it off for me, you know, and we took it in the studio. Matter of fact, Paul Reiser did the strings for that. And we had the bass player at the time, Kern Bradley, played. who is the music director for Lady Gaga, and also his sister's song on it too. Her name was Erinette. Eric and Erinette's song on that song. So it actually never came out, but I remade it and I put it on my album as a part of my first CD.
Okay.
And I put his name on it, everything. He heard the song, he thought it was great, you know, as an instrumental. And I had a gentleman who I thought sounded like Eric sing on it. His name was Gerard Brooks. He's also from Detroit, and he's a gospel singer. He has several projects out on his own.
Really impressed with the vocal quality.
Yeah.
From those days that you were doing that.
Yeah, he actually gave me the foundation of harmony. Although I learned that in school too, and the different rules to harmony when you're doing string arrangements. Those are things that you have to go to school to learn. Some people can figure it out, you know, because they may play keyboards and things like that. Because, you know, in our classes, we had to play keyboards to write our songs out, because keyboard is really the easiest instrument to play, and it has the whole range of the harmony. So you have the low all the way to the high. You have the lowest low, and you have the highest high, and everything else in between. So keyboard is what you use to learn to write that stuff. And I wasn't a good keyboard player, but I learned the rules to play. And if I had the melody, I didn't need the keyboard to write out the harmonies. I already could just write them out.
Wow.
Yeah.
So now, continuing with that evolution.
Yeah, that's where we at. Like I said, Eric was the one who really focused me in. He really gave me the understanding of the business itself, you know, where the money comes from. And he mentioned, you know, the different companies and the different tracking agencies and those sort of things. He mentioned, you know, copyrights and how to do that. He showed me how to do all that stuff. Like I said, he was really my mentor as I was growing up. And he would take me into his house, and we would listen to songs he recorded, and we would critique those songs. And he would say, "You're right, and this is what we need to do, and this is what we need to do." And then I would go in the studio with him, and we talked about what to do, and we would actually do it. So he gave me almost everything I needed to know in probably like the next 2 or 3 years. So, you know, he was like my mentor. After college, and we put the One Wish group together, it was really based on all the knowledge he gave me. And then going into the solo projects as D. Brown, I took that information in with me, and I hope that's why my vocals sound good. I hope that's why, because of what he embedded me in how to produce that stuff.
Well, I invite everyone to go to the website, dbrownmusic.com, and let me read to you the bio that exists there. Every now and then, one new artist emerges that not only brings it all, but compels you to feel it all. That person is D. Brown. As one of the world's best-kept secrets, guitarist, songwriter, arranger, producer, and vocalist D. Brown is definitely one for whom you will take notice. He demonstrates a sense of character that comes from deep spirituality and presents a musical entree that is appetizing and sweet. His new single, Honeycomb, from the up-and-coming album Brown Sugar, Honey-Coated Love, debuting on Intervision Records, will be a tasty treat for jazz lovers. Foundationally inspired by Proverbs 27:7, which says, "A satisfied soul loathes the honeycomb, but to a hungry soul, every bitter thing is sweet." D offers satisfying music that is so often missing from today's musical landscape. His stated purpose of this new release is to promote unity, appreciation, togetherness, and sharing. Possessing a solid musical background, D has performed with artists such as Nate Harrison, Aretha Franklin, B.B. and C.C. Winans, Paul Taylor, Randy Scott, Michael Winans, and Gail Johnson, just to name a few. D. Brown is a multi-talented phenomenon and is highly sought after. He is firmly committed to the craft and is definitely taking his vision and music to the top. Experience more of his God-given talent at www.dbrownmusic.com. Again, our guest. Now,
wow.
D. Brown.
Bam. Wow. I want to tap on that one. Thank you very much.
Go ahead.
You know, he has media here. First of all, take a look at the page. Take a look at the site. I love the show sites. Now you're talented in that way. You do graphics, any other stuff like that? You know, I'm just asking because sometimes I run into folks and they go, "I did the website." So I don't know.
You know, I did not do that website. I'm really not into websites and that kind of graphic kind of
endeavor. You can't do it all. Like, I don't work on cars.
No, I don't work on cars either.
See,
I get my hands dirty. I can't play my guitar with dirty hands.
Do all that tech. You can't work on a car. I could have.
No.
Anyway, but you had some other things here, like the media.
Right.
How about this piece right here? This one, Sunny.
Right.
Comes up also when people go to YouTube.
Right. Sunny is the is a track that my father, I dedicated to my father. My father was my biggest critic, and like I said, he really loves music, and like I said, he listened to it all his life. At the time, he was in his fight, with cancer. I took the three songs into the room to let him listen to it. He heard the three songs. He said, "Son, I like all three of them, but that second song, that's your hit." At the time, I had no name for it, and it's going to glory. I decided to name the song Sonny after him and also dedicate the whole CD to my father, wow, who is my hero.
Well, let's go take a look at this.
Okay.
And then, you know, everybody stay tuned also because D. Brown is going to play live. Again, I just wanted to give us a glimpse into this person that is so, so much more than just another jazz guitarist. Take a look. Here's D. Brown's Sonny.
In everyone's life, there comes a person that seems to make sense of things they are struggling to understand. In my case, it was the most obvious person. The first man that came into my life. My dad, George Sonny Brown. Sonny was a strong, loving, kind man who believed he was the man of his house and would provide everything necessary for his children and wife. Growing up in our house, I had little knowledge of the gospel, but many times I would hear my mother recite Ephesians 6, 1-3. "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment, with promise, that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth." George Sonny Brown accepted Jesus as his Lord and Savior late in his life, and it took the love of his family that he loved so much to bring him to the gospel. My dad, Sonny, was a drummer as a youth, but family obligations would not allow him to pursue music as a professional. He loved the players of the bebop era, players like Miles Davis, Charlie Parker, Lee Morgan, Eddie Jefferson. But when I heard the guitar of Wes Montgomery, I mentioned to Sonny, that was the instrument I wanted to play. I'll never forget the time I asked my dad for a new guitar. It was a time that everybody was talking about the Strat. So of course, Dad, I wanted to get a Stratocaster. I tried to get my mom to ask for me, but she said, as mothers often do, "Son, you have to speak up for yourself." So here is my tribute to the man who is my hero, my father, George Sonny Brown.
Yeah! Thank you. Song Sunny. Listen to Pax Area Live and our guest, D. Brown. Dedicated today. I know, chat room. I'm feeling it to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody. Our guest.
That was tight.
Our guest, D. Brown, everybody.
That was tight, man.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys watched that video there, but basically that video was about me as a kid. I didn't set it up. Me as a kid trying to get...
Oh, yeah, I was checking that out. I was shocked.
Okay, because I already had my guitar. But I was trying to get my father to buy me a professional guitar. That's what that was about. I wanted to get me a Strat. And here I am. You're like 15. Now I want to get a Strat. But I was trying to get my mother to ask. She said, no, you ask him for it. You know? And actually, the lady who played my mother is my sister. That's my sister, Toni Brown.
Okay.
And the gentleman.
Nice.
Yeah. The gentleman that played... those were actors from my church, actually. Those are actually the guy who played me was an actor, and the guy who played my my father was one of the actors.
Who scripted and directed this?
You know, it was actually my idea to do the video this way, and you know, I had to, you know, do that voiceover thing and make it look like it, you know, But it was done by a gentleman named Rodney Reynolds. He was the the PA stuff. In the church, whatever he was
PA
over
stuff.
PA stuff ministry. Oh, that's terrible.
How about the
audio?
Let's
just say audio ministry.
Audio, right.
Okay. So audio and visual ministry. He was over that, and you know, he put that together for me, and we talked about doing it, and we did a bunch of video, a bunch of tapes, and he just put the thing together, and it was really kind of his masterpiece, and me saying, okay, I like it.
Well, we got a chance to see the past and bring it all forward with this artist, D. Brown. And as you can see, and it didn't even get into really all the enterprising things. We know he's got business things that we could talk about in terms of the label and doing his own releases and that kind of thing.
Wow.
But we know we wanted to hear him play.
About time,
and he came prepared to play. Now, he brought three different things here. Now, I forgot which one, D, what we're going to do first.
Believe
but you tell
it
me
can.
What.
I like to do is I like to do the song entitled Believe It Can. This was off of my second CD entitled Little Elbow Room. This tune was the very first tune written. Just to give you a little insight, I had the record company. They told me, they said, well, D. Brown, you know, continue to work on songs, you know, throughout the year, and I'll give you about 6 months before I actually need the full CD. So, you know, I was a procrastinator. So they called me in January and said, D. Brown, we need the full CD by June. And I said, okay. At the time, I had no songs written, nothing. I haven't even picked my producers or anything like that. This was the very first tune that I wrote with a gentleman by the name of Chip Dixon. He played all the instruments. I played the guitar. It was one of his ideas mainly. And I wrote it Believe It Can, and because in the words of the Lord, if you believe you can do it, you can. So your belief have to be strong in what it is you're trying to do. So that's why I named it Believe It Can.
Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our guest. D. Brown.
Mm-hmm.
What can you say? That's our guest, everybody. Ooh. Dee Brown.
Mm, man.
Thank you very much.
Believe it can. Believe it can.
Believe.
You know, so much it seems like spirituality, as we were hearing, it's a big part of what you've been doing.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Sounds like from the early days on.
Well, as you saw in the video, that wasn't a big part of my life growing up as a child. My mother would mention it sometimes, but and I knew there was a God. I knew there was Jesus. I didn't really understand it. That didn't come in until later in my life. How I stayed out of a lot of trouble was because of music. Because music mm-hmm. puts you in a place where, in order to be better or get good, you have to constantly, you know, work on it. So my friends were musicians, and we were always playing. We were always working on playing instead of being out in the streets, you know, getting high, stealing, or doing any kind of criminal acts. So our concentration was in playing. So my father was there, and he was like the man. If he say do it, you do it. So he was kind of like the judge and jury. Like I said, I remember getting one whooping, but it was just the way he carried himself that you gave him respect, and he would give you everything that you ever wanted. And I don't have that rags to riches. I didn't grow up poor. I didn't grow up wanting. I always had everything. Everything I ever wanted, he gave me. That's what my father did for me. So that's what I have to, you know, instill and try to pass on to the younger generation too, that, you know, if you're a father, you got to be a father. You got to take care of your kids. And you got to be there for them. And it's very important for them to look up to you so that they can have some kind of role model. You know, and it's very important. And that's, you know, kind of like my spirituality. Later on, I really wanted to play in church because I really wanted to understand, you know, what this guy thing was about, because everybody would talk about it. So I had an opportunity to play in a church called First Baptist World Changes. I believe I joined like 2006 or 2005, something like that. So I play there, and that's you heard of World Changers? That's the Creflo Dollars.
Yeah, yeah.
There. And that's the sister church there in Detroit.
Wow.
So I play there every Sunday and Wednesday, and when I'm there, and I can play.
Still fun. Everybody, we're visiting with jazz guitarist. I don't know if I want to limit him in that way. He's yeah. got so many kinds of music. Songwriter, ooh, producer, Dee Brown here. We've got a chance to examine some of his past. He's played one track for us. Now, there's another track here, yeah. Natural Love.
Yes. Natural Love is the new single that's out right now. As you know, being signed to a regular record label, you have obligations. So when I signed with the company, I had to put out the first tune, which was Honeycomb. And they said, within a year, we need a full CD. So to complete my obligation, I put out the full CD, and the second single on it is Natural Love. Right now, we're on, I believe, 3 or 4 major charts right now. And on the Groove chart, I believe we're number 14. So we're in the top 20 with that. And we still have that bullet. So we're still going up. You know,
Wow.
Bang, man. Go Congratulations.
Ahead. Still going up.
Wow.
Give it to them, everybody.
Wow.
All right, we're getting ready to hear again from our guest, guitarist D. Brown, and here's his song, Natural Love.
Everybody was saying in the chat room, and like I said, you sound a little bit like Dave Koz and Kirk Whalum. And somebody said, G. Benson. I said, yes, I hear that too. It's like you, it's like you have everybody's signature just a little bit. It's like you tap into it and we can hear and relate to it. So you don't hear too many artists that could do that in combination. So we give you big, big mad love.
Well, thank you so much.
Because I was over here about to faint.
It really makes you wonder about the CD. Now, is that available? Because I'm also curious. Are you singing on any of the tracks? Are the tracks all guitar?
Well, you know, it's funny that you guys said GB, okay?
That's why I had to ask.
It's funny you should say GB. Because, you know, I'll tell you a short story. How much time we got? Do we got time?
We got time to do whatever
Come
you
on.
Want.
That's right.
That's my man, my man.
And we got chicken outside, too.
You got chicken. Makes everything good, right?
Oh, my God.
But here's a story. And this is kind of like my opinion. And, you know, I don't want to, you know, damper anyone's beliefs of what they think and, you know, how they perceive music. But for me, as a guitar player, my father introduced me, like I said, to Wesley Montgomery, Charlie Christian, and George Benson.
Oh, my God.
Okay, and also our homeboy from Detroit, Grant Green. Now, I don't know if you guys know about Grant Green, but Grant Green was an incredible guitar player. He played incredible licks that, I mean, this is early, you know, in the 60s and, you know, in the 50s, that were really, he was like a pioneer for this kind of stuff. George Benson came around later, okay, and he came around after Wes Montgomery as well, and he listened to these guys and these artists that, you know, he looked up to. I left out Django Reinhardt as well. I don't know if you guys heard of him, a French gentleman who is just incredible with his picking. And what George did was he perfected everything that Grant Green was trying to do. He perfected all those lines that you might hear him do a little slipping on. He perfected all that stuff. And I look up to George as, you know, being the best recorded guitarist alive as far as jazz. And I believe that all the jazz guitar players out there are trying to strive to be at his level, and not so much as playing, as it is to prominence in the music.
Well, to be accepted, I mean, how often do solo instrumentalists get acknowledged in today's world? And especially when you think about it, a lot of people don't realize how young an instrument the electric guitar actually is, when Les Paul essentially invented this.
Right.
Oh, wow.
This guitar. So it's not an this is not an instrument that's been around for a long time, and therefore these are the pioneering people who actually were reinventing it.
Exactly.
With styles of play, different styles of play, and adding new things to this instrument. So, again, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah. Well, he has the chat room melting.
I try to, you know, take things from those different players that I hear. And I think with my approach is mainly melody. That's my main approach. So when you hear my songs, you'll hear a lot of melody because of my singing. I want to play the melody over the chords as opposed to just playing a bunch of notes. And sometimes I play a lot of notes too. But I really like to adhere to the melody. So when those songs come on, you hear the melody very strong. And then you'll branch off into, you know, more playing and ad-lib and those sort of things.
Well, go to the website, everyone. Go to the website where you can find out and get more. He has it. Remember, the website is www.dbrownmusic.com. Take a look right here. You can go there. D, any special messages you want to send out to the folks? Wonderful response again from the chat room. All of our good folks. And again, got to acknowledge your boy. You brought your boy with you here tonight.
Yes, I brought my bass player, my main man, Mr. Dave Henderson.
There he is.
Has a CD
man.
Out as
yeah.
well.
Yeah.
Man.
He has his CD out as well. His CD came out a couple months ago. He has a new single out right now. It's called In Flight. And look for his CD as well. He's up there. You know, go ahead and Google Painted Funk. And funk is spelled P-H-U-N-K.
Well, I got his card, so we'll be looking at that and maybe.
You know, there's one more thing that's really, really odd here that I like to do and see if this might fit into what we're doing. You know, we were talking about, did I have anything else I wanted to acknowledge? There's a new video that's out that came out about maybe a month and a half ago, that I did a recording with a saxophonist named Gerald Albright.
Oh, yes, oh. Gerald Albright.
Wow. And also a singer, a gospel Riverside. Singer by the name of Ann Nesby.
Yes. Oh, well, yeah, yes, of course. Sounds, is that Sounds of Blackness?
Sounds of Blackness. Yeah. She came from. And she's a very strong vocalist, reminds you of a young Aretha Franklin. We did a song called Unity, and it's a video that's up on it. It's called Unity. It's put in LG Factory, and that's the label that actually put it out, and it's dedicated to, you know, us as people coming together in unity instead of just fighting each other, and knowing that this is the place that we have to all live. There's no other place to go but here. And if you get a chance, you know, bring that song up, check it out. It's got some really good, it's, the video is excellent, the music is excellent, and it's going to come out as a smooth jazz tune as well. And this one that's on the web in right now with the video is the gospel version of the song. But it's a very, very, very strong track, and it's going to be, you're going to hear this tune a lot really, really soon.
Well, let's take a listen, everyone.
We know the battle ahead will be long, but always remember that no matter what obstacles stand in our way, nothing can stand in the way of the power of millions of voices calling for change.
Unity, you what we need. Back in the day, brothers and sisters, marching in hand for equality. When time got rough, they turned to each other for strength and love and unity. We must stay strong and encourage our brothers in times like these. Right.
Unity. You heard it here. Pack Stereo Live 2015. Bringing you everything that's hot. D. Brown on a mission. You understand. Unity. Come on, y'all. Thank you, chat room. Happy birthday, Martin. Because of you, we have a dream. Gerald Albright, D. Brown, and Nesby.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Everybody. Wow. 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 Well, thank you all for tuning in. This has been Pack Stereo Live, the show that brings you the hot breaking things, the hot breaking artists. I want to thank again our guest, D. Brown. www.dbrownmusic.com. Thank you to all the folks tuning in from overseas. You know how we do it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's been that kind of day. Gotta have to watch this one over and over again. Go get some of that D. Brown music. Want to thank my partners in crime. Hot Chocolate. Sexy, sexy, sexy. Nico Williams, the mistress of chat, doing her thing. And then my brother over there, Victor Allen, all the while live on air, working three video switchers, painting visual pictures.
What? I don't like that name.
With the brushes.
I don't like that switching name, bro.
Okay.
Stop switching.
Call it engineering. They call it fake engineering.
Look, it's T-O-T.
Oh, that's cool.
T-O-T.
I don't even know what that means.
Tear.
That was thinking something else. Thank you all for being part of this experience. Peace and blessings.
All day. Peace, you guys.
Yeah.
Bang.
It's a power rush, a burning rush. You make me want to fly. Oh, getting out of this traffic jam. Dangerous and without a plan. Fill me up, boy, and let me ride. Crazy love, it's a crazy love. Feel the wind blowing through my hair. So alive, boy, and I'm so scared. Never knew love could move so fast. Crazy love, it's a crazy love. Pour it on, boy. Take me to the night. And ain't no stopping. So what's the use in trying? Destination. Baby, all I know is that you and me were meant to be. Never let me go. You make me feel like